Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14.5 Beta 3 has been out for a couple of days, and it has quite a few new features in it, and there's even more that I didn't mention in the first video. Now, as we get closer to the final release of iOS 14.5, we're going to see less and less features, and Apple starting to really nail down the feature set that's within the updates, and then making sure they're stable before they release them. I think 14.5 is a much better update than 14.4 with more features and fixes as well as security and privacy. And so I'm really looking forward to that. And I think it'll be a great advantage to many people once we have our phones even more secure. But there's even more features that I didn't mention in the first video. And the first thing has to do with a feature that's now available to everyone, not just for 14.5 Beta 3, but rather everyone that has an iPhone. And Apple has made a new website available, or really added a feature to a website that's already available, and you can see privacy.apple.com. Once you log in, you have a few different options, and one of the options is to transfer a copy of your data. So if we tap on this, it says request to transfer a copy of your data. We'll wait just a moment for it to load, and you'll see it says transfer a copy of your photos and videos. So you can transfer them from iCloud to, say, Google Photos. So right now, Google Photos is the only destination available, but maybe we'll have Amazon Photos in the future or additional services. But as you can see what it says in the top, it says copy your photos and videos from iCloud Photos to another participating service. This will take between 3 and 7 days. We use this time to verify that the request was made by you and to finish the transfer. And you'll see it tells you how many there are. So I have 25,978 photos and 1,339 videos using about 742 gigabytes. I need to change that, as many of these videos just need to be thrown away, but hopefully in the future we'll have some other features or other services that we can transfer this to. So that's something that's new that's available now. If you wanted to transfer those to another service, maybe you're switching to Android, or maybe you just don't want them in iCloud Photos, you can do that. Hopefully we'll have a way to export them as well. Just dump them onto a computer. That would be nice also. Now the next change has to do with Apple Watch. If you take your watch off of your wrist and put it back on and you have a passcode enabled, it will prompt you to put in that passcode. If you have the option turned on to unlock it with your phone, just by unlocking your iPhone, you can unlock the watch on your wrist because it's nearby. When you do that, it tells you that with a little dropdown. They've changed the icon in the dropdown. So this icon is changed. I just took a screenshot of it since it doesn't stay on the screen for long, but you can see the little watch icon has been updated. So that's new. Not a huge change, but something worth noting. Also, a developer found some new icon packs for developers. So Jeff Hackworth here on Twitter found that there's new symbols, or SF, that's San Francisco, their font. There's new symbols for things such as AirPods. We'll zoom in here, but there's new symbols for AirPods and things like that, and HomePod as well. So you can see those here. If I scroll over, you'll see there's some new symbols as well. These are just for use within applications if you want to use those with HomePod Mini, HomePod, and HomePod itself. So that's a slight change. It's available to developers, not something you can physically see, but it's there. Now, a feature they've brought back has to do with setting your music as a default to, say, Spotify, for example. So maybe you want to use Spotify instead of Apple Music. Well, we thought this was a default music setting change, but Apple has clarified this. So you can ask Siri to play a song in, say, Spotify. It'll say, you can play a song, and it'll say, who do you want to play this song through, meaning Apple Music or Spotify, and it will change and then continue to play through that. However, there's no setting for it. Apple has said that this is just basically intelligence-based so that Siri can learn what you like to listen to over time. It's not actually a default setting. I wish they'd bring that setting into music here. It would be great to see them put a setting within the music app just to change that and then allow us to select what we want for default, whether that be Google Music, or I guess YouTube Music at this point, as well as Apple Music, Spotify, Tidal, anything else. One of those would be nice to be able to switch to if that's what your preference is. Now, someone had sent in that they've made some album change or album artwork changes when you're in different music, for example. So if we search for someone here, you can see there are different album animations, but this is different based on the artist, for example. So here we have two popular artists, and it's not on every artist, so I just picked this, but you'll see the one on the left is moving. The one on the right's moving now, and it's just a little bit different between the artists. This is mostly just because that's what the artist chose. So it's not really too big of a change, but I wanted to point that out. Since album covers could vary how it's zooming in the album, it may be outlined a little bit differently, but you'll see it's moving back out now. So they've made some nice animations. It's not on every album. Maybe in the future it will be. Now within the Find My app, a week or so ago when I talked about beta 2, there was some mention in the code that the phone could notify you if you're using that new feature where you can track items within Find My to let you know that your item is being tracked. Maybe you have someone else's item by accident, or you have an AirTag or some other tag that's being tracked. Whether this uses that or not is hard to say, but whether or not you have that, it will let you know that it's being tracked and relaying back to the owner that you're using that. Now, it doesn't tell you who it is. There isn't an identifier, but someone was able to find that there's a little pop-up that will show this. And if we go over to photos here, here's a little screenshot, and you can see it says turn off item safety feature. The owner of an unknown item will be able to see your location, and you will no longer receive notifications when an unknown item is found moving with you. So this is good and bad in the sense that the data is anonymous, but say someone takes one of your possessions that has one of these tags in it, they may be able to turn off that notification. It's unclear if Apple is just turning off the notification or disabling maybe location services for this as well through your device, since it relays that information. It'll be interesting to see if there's more options for this in the future. Now within settings, quite a few people have been messaging me about a new setting that showed up for them. So let's go into settings. And if we scroll down, keep scrolling, you'll see TV provider. Now this has been here for a while in certain countries like the United States. However, it seems to be rolling out to other countries according to a lot of you. And so what this does is allow you to use your TV provider. So maybe you subscribe to a television provider locally, whether that's combined with internet like it is in the United States usually. What it lets you do is easily sign into applications such as local news stations that would let you stream TV for free. So by using that sign on, you'd be able to do that. Maybe free apps as well. So as you can see here, it says AT&T UVerse has been saved as your TV provider. Because AT&T UVerse is not participating in single sign-on, you will need to sign in to other supported apps individually. All this does is allow you to sign in seamlessly between your provider if it supports it. So maybe you have, in the United States, maybe you have Comcast or Xfinity or one of those services. You log into it, log into, say, your favorite news station, or maybe even HBO Go or something like that, you may be able to get free services if you sign in with your TV provider. So this has been fairly common in the United States, but it seems to be rolling out elsewhere. Now, in addition to the things I've already mentioned, there's additional mentions within the code to things like Siri. For example, there's new Siri car commands that could be implemented in the future, maybe when you're using Apple CarPlay to help better use features or give you more features, for example. Also, Siri may be able to modify contacts in the future, which could be kind of interesting, assuming that it works properly and doesn't mess up your contacts. Hopefully it would confirm that information to you, I would imagine. And then also, Siri may be able to tell you about traffic when you're in your car. So maybe you're leaving for work and you want to know how the traffic is. It would better understand that and give you that information based off maybe a commute you've set or maybe some navigation point you've added in Maps. So it would be able to do that. Also, there's talk of Apple working on Siri to help it better understand people with disabilities or that need accessibility or have issues with speech, for example. So maybe you have an issue with stuttering, it would be able to better understand you with that. So there's definitely some work going into Siri with speech recognition, and it's great to see them working on this. Now, there's also one final thing I wanted to mention that's in the code that I thought was interesting is that there's SensorKit UI facial metrics and speech metrics that seem to be related to future health studies. Now, we've had health studies for a while that use maybe the Apple Watch to measure your heart and give that information back to universities should you opt in to do that. And it's completely opt-in, so if you want to do it, you can. If you don't, you don't have to. But there's future feature releases that seem to be related to the iPhone's ability to detect facial expressions and listen for different sounds that are emotion related, such as laughing, shouting, or maybe something else. So it could use that information from the microphone and the camera to better help health studies understand human expression and maybe different metrics they're trying to measure. So again, it's nice to see them add features, but again, it's opt-in and you don't have to do that. Now with the iPad, like I said before, it's had terrible battery life for me, and that's still continuing with beta 3. So you'll see that it was last charged to 100% at 2:05 a.m. this morning, and we're down to 57%, and I've hardly used it. So I've used it about an hour or so. Maybe 3 hours at most, and it's draining the battery very rapidly. And so this seems to be a problem for me continually on the iPad. And I think at this point, I'm just going to wait for iOS 14.5 and iPadOS 14.5 to release to the public. And I'll probably just completely restore it and start over and see if that fixes it. Since Apple generally says if you continue to have problems to do that and it should fix it. So I'll try that then. And as far as a follow-up, as far as bugs and other things that may not be working and other things that are working well, I'll be doing a follow-up in a couple days, and I have a YouTube community poll available. And at this time, it's got 3,500 votes or so, 3.5K votes. And if you want to vote and comment, that's always helpful so we can get accurate data about the overall experience. So I'll be having a follow-up in a couple days about that. So be sure to go there if you are interested in participating. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.